Good morning. This is Billy again, and this is another video project for
Flippin' Physics.
Mr. P asked me to show that the conservation of energy problem with friction and incline and a spring, which I did, can also be solved using the work due to friction equals change in mechanical energy equation. So here goes. We have the same problem. A block with a mass of 11 grams is used to compress a spring a distance of 3.2 centimeters. The spring constant of the spring is 14 newtons per meter. After the block is released, it slides along a level, frictionless surface until it comes to the bottom of a 25-degree incline. If the coefficient of kinetic friction between the block and the incline is 0.30, to what maximum height does the block slide? Again, we list our known values and convert to base SI units. But now, we need to use the work due to friction equals change in mechanical energy equation. We can use this equation because there is work done by a force of friction, however, there is no work done by a force applied. Expanding out the equation gives us the work due to friction equals the force of kinetic friction times the displacement of the block times the cosine of the angle between those two vectors. And the change in mechanical energy equals mechanical energy final minus mechanical energy initial. Notice the force of friction only acts on the block while it is on the incline. So the work due to the force of friction is only while the block is on the incline. The angle between the force of kinetic friction, which is down the incline, and the displacement of the block, which is up the incline, is 180 degrees. Let's set our initial point to where the spring is at its maximum compression, and let's set the final point to where the block is at its maximum height. Also, let's set the horizontal zero line at the center of mass of the block while it is on the horizontal surface. Now, let's identify the mechanical energies. The initial velocity of the block is zero, so there is no initial kinetic energy. The initial height of the block is zero, so there is no initial gravitational potential energy. There is an initial compression of the spring, so there is elastic potential energy initial. The final height of the block is not zero, so there is gravitational potential energy final. The final velocity of the block is zero, so there is no kinetic energy final. The block is not compressing the spring at the end, so there is no elastic potential energy final. Substituting in the equation for the force of kinetic friction gives us the coefficient of kinetic friction times force normal times the displacement in the parallel direction times the cosine of 180 degrees, which equals mass times acceleration due to gravity times height final minus 1/2 times the spring constant times the initial compression of the spring squared. Let's put that in our equation holster because we need to find the force normal. Let's draw a free body diagram and sum the forces in the perpendicular direction. The force normal is up and perpendicular to the incline. The force of gravity is straight down, and the force of kinetic friction is parallel to the incline and opposite the direction of motion, or down the incline. We can break the force of gravity into its components, the force of gravity perpendicular to the incline and down, and the force of gravity parallel to and down the incline. The net force in the perpendicular direction equals force normal minus force of gravity perpendicular, and the net force in the perpendicular direction also equals mass times the acceleration in the perpendicular direction. The block isn't moving perpendicular to the incline, so the acceleration perpendicular is zero, and therefore the force normal equals the force of gravity perpendicular, which equals mass times acceleration due to gravity times the cosine of the incline angle, which we can substitute back into the equation in our equation holster. And we can also substitute in -1 for the cosine of 180 degrees. Other than the height final, which is the maximum height we are solving for, the only variable we do not have in this equation is the displacement in the parallel direction. So we can draw a triangle and get the sine of the incline angle equals opposite over hypotenuse. Opposite the incline angle is the height final, and the hypotenuse is the displacement in the parallel direction. Rearranged in the equation gives us the displacement in the parallel direction equals the height final divided by the sine of the incline angle, which we can substitute back into the equation we were just working with. Because sine theta divided by cosine theta equals tangent theta, we now have negative coefficient of kinetic friction times mass times acceleration due to gravity divided by tangent theta, all times height final equals mass times acceleration due to gravity times height final minus 1/2 times the spring constant times the initial compression of the spring squared. Then we multiply through by -1 and move gravitational potential energy over to the other side so we can take out the common factor of mass times acceleration due to gravity times height final. Then we can solve for the height final by dividing both sides by mass times acceleration due to gravity times the quantity 1 plus the coefficient of kinetic friction divided by the tangent of the incline angle. Now we can substitute in numbers. The height final equals 1 half times 14 times 0.032 squared divided by the quantity 0.011 times 9.81 times the quantity 1 plus 0.3 divided by the tangent of 25 degrees, which works out to be, with two significant digits, 0.040 meters, which is exactly what we got the previous time we did this problem. The maximum height the block slides to is 0.040 meters. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.